him, that you love him.
Amen. Amen.
You know, that you love him.
Yes.
He wants you to know that you love him. Your husband, if you have a husband, he wants to know you love him. I'm not talking this way because I'm a girl. Okay, praise the Lord. And I thank God for that. I love being a girl. Give God glory. He's worthy. Praise the Lord. It's a little bit more in here. Okay. Praise the Lord. All right. This one is a good one. 1 Corinthians 12 and 25, 26. It says, that there be no schism in the body. My God. Lack of agreement. We need to be in harmony, no one preventing anyone to achieve their goals.
All right.
No discord. No division.
Right. No room for that.
There's no room for that.
There's no room for that.
You know, we got to be doing it because there's a lot of stuff going on. You know what I'm saying? We need to stop it. Praise the Lord. I just say it just needs to stop. Praise the Lord. God's concerned about us physically. And then he gave us that we have one mind. And he has compassion. One, we should have compassion one for the other. And socially, that God in heaven, he doesn't have any respect for persons. You know, he don't look one person this way and one person the other way. You know, he loves us all the same. Ain't no big eyes, no little you, like Pastor said today. No, you know, putting one up and putting one down. And coming against and discouraging somebody. I hate when somebody gets discouraged. It goes right to the pit of my stomach. It hurts so bad to watch to see somebody's discouraged. And they're not able to go forth and do the things they need to go to. We need to encourage one another.
Yes.
Just go to one another and say, "Let's, you know, you're good at what you do. Please continue to do it. It's going to be all right."
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
We have to stay together.
Yes.
We have to work together in oneness and unity. We have to do this.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And mentally, that he that glory, let him glory. If there be any glory, if there be any, let it be in him. If there be any honor, let's honor God.
Amen.
If there be any honor, everything that we do should please him. When we go and we talk to people, and if we're saying things that we're not supposed to say, which we do wind up doing sometimes, you know, we need to take those words back and render a crop failure that don't come up on them people and it doesn't come up on us. Most of the time it comes back on us. He said that it's so, you better be, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that's what he's going to reap. A lot of times it don't be them that get mocked. It's like when Pharaoh mocks Moses, it was him. He lost his child, his firstborn. You don't mock God. You know what I'm saying? A lot of times we criticize people, we come against people, and a lot of times that stuff comes back on us. And we wonder why we can't get out of our hole. We're in a big, deep hole that we cannot climb out because we got our mouth wide. Well, God, you know, we ain't got no business being saying things that we should have no business saying. Praise the Lord. Let's just watch. Let's just watch and let God help us. You know, like I said, the husband is the first partaker of the fruit. You know what I'm saying? I just thank God. Each and every one of you. I thank you for your love for me. And I want to stay with you. And you're not going to get rid of me. So don't try. I ain't going nowhere. I was thinking about First Lady. We had a meeting yesterday. First Lady said, this place is blessed. Yes, it is. It's always clean. It's always pleasant. We're blessed. You know, let's give God praise and give God glory. Hallelujah. I looked to each and every one of you for it every time I come in contact with you. You always have something encouraging to say to me. And I thank you for it. And I thank you for listening to me today. Praise the Lord, for God is good. He is so good. He is so good. Bless the name of the Lord. Thank you very much. God bless you.